motivation, a lot of drive. My husband thinks I've been in a better mood. Our relationship, all I can say is it's a lot better now.
I've just started taking Super Female Vitality from InfoWarsLife.com. Supplies are limited, so secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or dial 1-888-253-3139.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
You know, it really shows how controlled the networks are in this country, because that's what targets the mainline public that doesn't know their hands from their butt in many cases because of the upbringing of the media brainwashing system. We've got John Rappaport on the line with us, investigative journalist. No more fake news. This is a short segment, bunch of long segments coming up, and I want him to really be able to get into the conspiracy to shut off our old industry while blocking new energy, while acting like they're for the new energy. So I'm going to give him the floor from 24 after to the end. That's about 30 minutes of airtime with John Rappaport. I don't even have to go anywhere. I just want to turn the show over to him and listen. So that's coming up with John Rappaport today, and I'll be back tomorrow with the show with Paul Watson, David Knight, and a bunch of other people, a bunch of big guests coming up this week. But you were getting into the real reality of Afghanistan. I've got my breakdown reality of what it's really like, just a big hole to dump money into, a full-spectrum dominance globalist system. Break down your take on Afghanistan, then we'll go to break, come back, mention Bilderberg, a few other issues, and then get into free energy.
No question about it. It's, as you say, a full-spectrum dominance operation. It's also drugs. It's also, you know, a rise in the poppies. Lots more poppies growing since we went over there. The opium is flowing. The opium has to be kept flowing. There's a long-standing project to build an oil pipeline through there. There's all kinds of military, geopolitical, economic reasons we're over there. And then, of course, you've got the rules of engagement, which would drive anybody crazy. You know, do you have to call back to get permission to kill somebody in case you don't know who they are and they might have a gun and they're ready to kill you? And you're going to do two or three tours like this? I mean, the whole idea that, yes, we're over there, we're an army, we're not just an intelligence group, but we're an army, we're killing people, this is a war, but we can only kill certain people a certain amount of the time, and we're helping other people build villages and so forth, all at the same time. This is not what an army does. This is not the way an army can operate. This creates crazy people, people that want to walk away, people that want to kill themselves. And then you put them on all kinds of psychiatric drugs, which they use to self-medicate themselves over there, that cause suicide, like the SSRI antidepressants. And you've got a complete catastrophe, as witnessed by what's happening at the VA now. So I go back to saying this is a major distraction, this whole prisoner exchange thing, to cover up the deep corruption at the VA.
Well, I agree with you. Man, I tell you, I mean, I know they built Obama up as the savior, and he's meant to be politically destroyed by the end so a new savior can come in, but he is rotting on the vine really fast right now. I mean, can they leave him in another 2 years or will he end up getting impeached or something?
I don't see any way he can be impeached. He's there till the end. And then they're all, the media are all going to try to celebrate his presidency and do all sorts of, you know, retrospectives. You can count on, you know, endless amounts.
Exactly. They'll tear him down, let him fall on the sword, then they'll build him back up later.
Sure. Just like they did to Clinton. And you even see it a little bit with Bush. They always do the same thing. And Obama is going to take place in the pantheon of great presidents eventually by revisionist history.
But that finally comes to an end. I mean, the cynicism, the 9% approval rating, as low as 6% for Congress. I mean, this is not the same old cycle anymore. I don't see him getting away with it. I want to talk about that with you when we get back. And something we talked about on the Sunday show, that's why I wanted to get you back today, because we ran out of time. Let's spend some time on positive stuff first. What it is to be free, where the world's going, how we can change ourselves inside to change the world outside. Then we'll get into energy and the energy game they're playing. I agree with your analysis, some of the articles you've written at nomorefakenews.com. I want you to break down that deep, informed view coming up straight ahead, and a little bit of Bilderberg news with John Rappaport. I'm Alex Jones. This is GCNLive.com.
Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to Big Pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products, and get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip. From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States, well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Hi, I'm Dr. Edward Grubb. It took me 20 years of searching the globe to find the deposit of the highest purity iodine available. The new Survival Shield X2 is mined from 7 to 10,000 feet below the Earth in pristine, environmentally clean conditions. The iodine crystals we use are extracted from an ancient 300 million plus year old deposit deep in the earth. It's the strongest nascent iodine on the market today. It delivers 650 micrograms per drop. Experience the new formula. Experience the ancient purity. Shield your family. Survival Shield X2, available now at InfoWarsLife.com.
X2 from InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
Take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance. It's Alex Jones.
That's right, the great InfoWars.com crew with the nightly news studios and more are up there in Austin, Texas. I am down on the coast of Texas, one week, not even vacation, working vacation with my children so that we can do a little bit of body surfing and spend time with them before they grow up. But I'm down here pretty much working about half speed with the family, and we'll be co-hosting the news radio show all 5 days this week, at least part of the time. And we're going to have Paul Watson, David Knight, and so many others. Some of the stories up on InfoWars.com. Sergeant Burgle, if you pronounce it that way, release arranged by CIA terror group. Police interrogate protesters for entering Bilderberg Hotel a day after they leave. There's video of that by Paul Joseph Watson on InfoWars.com. White House launches propaganda at troll level, actually buying Google keywords now to put out their lies. Dems defend Obama's politically calculated release of terrorists. Bilderberg 2014, blown wide open, a big boil-down article. Bilderberg 2014, George Osborne and the man at the center of everything. Mental health screening, a good way to decrease liberty, poor way to increase security. Ron Paul, the velocity of money in the U.S. falls to an all-time record low as the money's devalued. But first, I wanted to finish up with Bilderberg and then get into some positive news with John Rappaport of NoMoreFakeNews.com, who's giving us his commentary today. And he'll be hosting the last 40 minutes of the show today just because I want to hear him do a presentation on what's really happening with energy. This affects everybody. I don't own stock in energy, or I don't work for it. Energy is your number one cost. And this is where they're really gaming us. You want to conquer somebody, control the energy. So we're going to, from the calories our kids eat to the oil in our cars to the coal power plants to the solar farms to the wind farms, it's all gamed, folks. The globalists are scientific in their takeover, read eco-science. They break down the control of energy at every level. But we saw them black out the windows at Bilderberg and put up fences and go to the greatest lengths ever in Copenhagen, Denmark, to block the public and the press this year. But then, on like the sixth floor, men all come up in robes, all holding on to each other, acting weird, and have some pretty boy come and wave at everybody and flaunt it at the media. And General Petraeus would come to the window and stare at people and others and, you know, just really act weird. And I guess they're really mad it's being exposed. They can't deny there's a shadow global government. This is really coming out. We're showing some video of that for TV viewers right now. Radio listeners can go to InfoWars.com and see the videos in HD. But what do you think's really behind all this? Black the windows out, but have multiple Bilderberg group members come out and talk to the press and the public saying we're no big deal. That have other Bilderberg members tell the German press we actually, you know, pretty much run things. And the leader of the Dutch parliament say, I don't violate the law being here to discuss government policy because we're public. Well, no, you're not public. So are they scared of indictment? There's talk of that in England. Why are they blacking out windows but leaving one open and having men, old men, parade around with a pretty boy, scantily clothed and in bathrobes? What is this really all about? Are they acting like they don't care that we know because they actually do care? John Rappaport.
It's a complicated situation, but point number one is I think they have to make a pretense that this is now public, because it is, because it's been exposed. So they can't go around anymore saying secret Bilderberg, because everybody knows about it now. Or, I mean, through InfoWars and other alternative media, people realize it. So they have to make a pretense of saying they're public. Otherwise, they could be indicted. They couldn't be indicted for doing national government business as an international secret society, which they are. So on the one hand, they've got to now sort of give the impression, hey, we're trying to conceal anything. Here we are, you know, and we'll have a conversation with you and so on and so forth. On the other hand, you've got some of the crazier members who are still back in the Stone Age trying to conceal the whole thing and blocking out windows. And then you've got the real loons in their, you know, white bathrobes doing God knows what. Reminds me of your old expose of the Bohemian Grove business. I mean, so I think you've got several different factions there operating at the same time, giving a contradictory appearance. But the main thrust here is I think they finally decided that they have to now pretend that they're out in the open so that they can avoid criminal prosecution. Because, I mean, you can't. No nation's laws permit government people to go to a secret international conference and make policy decisions outside their own government. I mean, they put you in prison for that if they catch you or if they want to catch you. So that's why I think you're seeing a little bit of this. Oh, you know, we're just a bunch of guys sitting around. Of course, we're meeting here. We're not trying to hide anything.
And I looked up the floor plan of that Marriott conference center. The gym is down on the lower floor. They were in a suite in a bunch of bathrobes, holding on to each other with a pretty boy in the middle of them, flaunting and teasing everyone. And, I mean, that's very sophomoric behavior. And I don't know what the point of it is. And I agree with you. It just, it shows different factions, and that's what it is.